So good afternoon, students. Today we are going to start the second lecture on the springs. So in the previous lecture, we have studied the closed coil helical spring, which is subjected to the axial load W, and we have derived, we have used these terms. And we have derived the different formulae. So once again to revise that, the torque in this case will be equal to the axial load multiplied by this d by 2. So using the torsion formula, I have written this torsion formula. So you can find the J is equal to, you know that J is equal to pi by 32 d 4. And L is equal to pi d into n. So if you calculate the, put the value of t over here, and you can bring the j in this side. So this r will be d by 2, where d is the diameter of the spring wire. Okay. So you can find the value of the shear stress, that is 8wd upon pi d cube. Similarly, if the this coil is subjected to the couple, so you see it is not subjected to the axial load W, so it is under the action of an axial torque T or the axial couple. Other things are same. So in this case, the material of the spring wire is subjected to pure bending, which tends to reduce the radius of coil, which is R. So in this case, the bending moment is constant throughout and the is equal to the applied torque T. So the stresses, that is the maximum bending stress, it can be given by the bending formula. So this you know from the bending formula, that was sigma B upon Y is equal to M upon I is equal to E upon R. So this is the bending formula we have studied. So from using this formula, you can find out the maximum stress. This is the bending stress. So this will be sigma B is equal to M into Y upon I. So this is what is written. So Y is D by 2, where D is the diameter here. Okay. So Y is the distance, as we have seen in the case of the torsion. If we, what kind of stresses will be set up? They will be shear in nature. So these stresses are maximum at the periphery and they are shear stresses. So we can denote them by this. And this is R, where R is equal to D by 2. Okay, so I have written, so maximum stress is here, so distance from the center is Y, so this is D by 2, and I is equal to pi D 4 upon 64. So therefore, by putting this value, you get the maximum bending stress, which is equal to 32 times T upon pi D 2. Okay. Now, in order to find the wind up angle or the deflection angle, which is theta. So theta is a wind up angle or the deflection angle. So first of all, under the action of the axial torque, the deflection of the spring becomes the wind up angle of the spring, which is the angle through which the one end turns related to each other. Because when you will apply the couple, so this these springs coil will try to come closer. This will be equal to the total change in the slope of the wire. So according to area moment theorem, we have to use this formula, that is integral 0 to L M into DL upon EI, and M is given here T. So you can put here 0 to L, so in place of M you have put T, DL upon EI. So this T upon EI is constant, so this you have taken outside. So therefore theta is equal to T upon EI. So when you will integrate this, it will become T upon EI. E upon EI, this integral will be equal to L, and when you will put the limit, so it will be 0 to L. So 0 to L. So on calculating this, it will be TL upon E into I. So theta is equal to TL upon EI. So we know that L is equal to pi d n and I is equal to pi d 4 upon 64. Therefore, putting this value of L and the value of I, you get this theta. Okay. So this way, this formula is different because it is under the action of an axial torque. Earlier formula was under the action of the axial load. Okay, so there are two cases we have discussed for the closed coil helical spring. Okay, one is under the action of the load and another is under the action of the couple T. So now the springs can be joined in the different fashion. So first of all, we'll take when the springs are joined in series. So as we have seen, in the case of resistance, electrical resistance, in the case of electrical resistance, so this is a one resistance R, and if they are joined in series, so we join the another resistance R here. So R1 is the resistance of the first resistor, R2 is the resistance of the second resistor. So this is one end, and this is another end. So the way we find the total resistance, similarly we'll find here what will be the total stiffness. This is one spring and this is another spring. So if they are joined from end to end and axial load W, this is the axial load. If it is applied at one end, so K1 and K2 are the stiffness of the each spring, and X1 and X2 are the extension or the deflection produced. Okay, so total deflection will be the X. Okay, so that will be equal to total load divided by the total deflection K. Let K be the stiffness of the equivalent spring, which is made here. So W upon X, K is equal to the capital X, that is the stiffness, that is the total extension produced by the this equivalent spring. So this will be the sum of the first extension plus sum of the second extension. So X1 will be W upon K1. So here you see, here the current remains same. Here the load is same. So W upon K1 and W upon K2. So X1 will be W upon K1, X2 will be W upon K2. So if you take this, so W will be common here, and this WW will cancel each other. So 1 upon K is equal to 1 upon K1. So you see, this case is analogous to electrical resistance, but the relation is converse. So here the total resistance is R. So in the case of the series, we have R1 plus R2. Okay. But here, though they are joined in series, but their total stiffness is 1 upon k upon 1 is equal to 1 upon k1 plus 1 upon k2. Similarly, we can join the springs in parallel. So in the case of the, you see, if the two resistors are joined in parallel, so what we do? We join these two resistors. One is this, another is this. This is R1, and say this is R2. And if the total resistance is T, so in this case, it will be equal to RT is equal to 1 upon R1 plus 1 upon R2. So if the two springs of the stiffness K1 and K2, they are joined in this fashion so that they are under the action of a common load W. So in this case, because the springs are of the same length, so they will be producing the equal extension. However, the load will be shared as per this equation, where W is the total load, W1 is the load taken by the spring, and W2 is the load taken by the second spring. So this extension, we can write this. So W upon K is equal to W1 upon K1 is equal to W2 upon K2. So therefore, W1 is equal to this and W2 is this. So you can put this value here. In this case, W will be there and W upon K1. So W1 and W2, these values you have put here. So if you solve this equation, so W is equal to W1, that is W upon K1 upon K, plus it will be W into K2 upon K. So you can write it as W into K is equal to, W will be common here. So in the bracket we can write K1 plus K2. So this WW will be cancelled. So you will be having this equation. So you see it is converse. Although they are joined in parallel, but their total stiffness is as if they are joined in series of the resistance. So it is very easy to remember. Now next is, what is the strain energy in the springs? The strain energy, as you know, is defined as the energy which is stored within a material when the work has been done on the material. So in the case of the spring, the strain energy is given by U is equal to half the load multiplied by the extension. So this extension formula we know from the first case. So the strain energy is equal to 32 W, this 2 will cancel from here. So it will be 32 W square R cube N upon GD power 4. Okay. So with this, I stop the lecture over here.